Any other questions or discussion?
I guess, all I would say is that, you know, in the next couple of weeks, I know I, for one, am going to really try to get out and ask my constituents. I just don't want to, I mean, I represent people, and I just don't want to assume that everyone is, you know, is for this. I mean, it's been discussed that there are several that are having some hard economic times. I'm not saying that the employees of Kirksville and those that service are not worthy of this, because I think they are. I, for one, I'm going to try to get out. I will vote for this tonight, but I'm going to get out and ask people what their opinion is for the second reading on the 21st.
Any other comments or discussion? Any other comments or discussion?
I have a comment. I just wanted to pass this down to Richard, Carolyn, Martha. This will look familiar to you guys. This is information the mayor provided to us March of this year. Just to refresh your memory when you are out talking to your constituents about why we are proposing to raise salaries this year for city employees by 2%. And I just encourage you and everybody else to take a larger lens look at this picture. Don't just look at this year, but look at the last 10 years and see how employee salaries have matched with cost of living increases. Here in this chart, and I can provide some copies for folks who want to see this, it shows from April 1998 until December 2008 what the amount was given by the council, the amount of cost of living increase to city employees, compared to the cost of living allowance that Social Security gets. Folks who are on Social Security, the percent increases that they get in order to keep up with cost of living. And you'll see that while some years we did match or even exceed, in a couple rare cases here, the cost of living increase provided for by the Social Security, actually there were a number of years where we were under it or we didn't give any increase at all. And so, for example, in April 2003, there was no increase for city employees while there was a 2.1% Social Security. In April 2005, there was 0% increase given to city employees while Social Security gave 4.1%. The last year, we did not increase employee salaries at all. We gave a one-time bonus while Social Security gave a 5.8% increase. And again, the year before that, total bonuses of looks like $700, when Social Security gave a 2.3% increase. And the sum total of all this, when you look at the bottom, is summed up. The total percent increase in salaries over the last 10 years for city employees is 22%, while the actual cost of living has increased by 31.6%, which means there's a 9.6% difference. So really, ideally, we would be increasing employee salaries by 9.6% to keep up with what we've been shortchanging them over these last 10 years. But we can't afford to do that. So what we are proposing and what we have found in the budget, not through any taxes, not through anything else, but by cutting things from the budget, is an extra $700,000 so that we can provide for a 2% increase. It still doesn't close that 9.6% gap, but it will bring us closer, particularly this year when there will be zero increase in Social Security. And hopefully we can continue to close that gap throughout the coming years.
I think we need to be careful about that 9.6%. And the reason I say that is because the cost of living assessment and the increase that we're talking about is a general guide for companies and for people like ourselves. And I think we have to, every community, every employer that employs people in the community, yes, he does realize that there is a cost of living increase, but he also realizes he lives in a specific geographic location, whereas the cost of living increase in California is going to be different than it is in Kirksville, and the cost of living increase in New York is going to be different than it is in Kirksville. So, I mean, it may be 7% for Kirksville, it may be 5% for Kirksville, but, you know, I just think we, to be dogmatic that we are 9.6% behind, I think we got to be careful about that. I agree we're behind, but I don't know how far behind. We may be farther behind than 9.6, who knows? I mean,
this is the guy that everybody goes by.
So. Well, I know, but I'm just saying.
Thank you for getting that, Todd.
Yes, it's good information, and I'll make sure to be fair to the constituents that is presented.
Any other comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
Aye.
Thank you. Our next is bill number 66.
Actually, Mayor, that should not be an ordinance.
I need a motion and a second to authorize the city manager to enter into an agreement with Willis Brothers for the Northeast Pump Station Force Main Realignment Project in the amount of $931,640.
So moved.
Second.